Hello everybody, welcome in today's video. Bitcoin reclaimed the 23,000 level and right now it's looking like we are trading in a sideways range. We are going to have a look at that, and guys, I'm going to show you a fractal with the run in 2019, which looks very similar to the price action we are seeing right now, and which is actually predicting a huge surge in the Bitcoin price if this fractal were to play out. Then guys, we will be having a look as well at a couple of other charts like Ethereum and the Bitcoin dominance, because we are seeing some interesting signs over there. I want to share that with you. So guys, all about that in today's video. With that being said, my name is Jeroen. Welcome to the Blockchain Today, the channel where you subscribe for daily crypto videos. And right now, let's jump into the Bitcoin TA. But guys, as always, before we are starting with the TA of today, let's all take a minute, scroll below this video and hit the thumbs up button. Guys, that would be amazing. And recently, guys, you've been amazing with the amount of likes, the amount of comments that I've received on these videos. And that really helped to push these videos to as much people as possible. So guys, let's see if we can keep up with this momentum. Then guys, for all the traders out there who are interested in trading Bitcoin or other assets, you can do that on a couple of exchanges. And I have some exchanges down below in the pinned comment. And when you use my sign up link to sign up for these exchanges, you can get an additional bonus. So I'm personally using these three exchanges, and the first one is the Prime XBT exchange, which I use to long and short Bitcoin, but as well other assets like the S&P 500. They also have a nice co-investing module where you can copy other traders, or other traders can copy you, where you can earn crypto based on their trades. And right now, when you sign up using my affiliate link down below, you can get a 50% deposit bonus and a 25% discount on your fees. Then the next exchange that I'm using is the Femix platform, where I'm trading Bitcoin and altcoins on the spot market, but as well with leverage. If you sign up using my affiliate link down below, you can get an additional bonus of $100 when you deposit 0.2 Bitcoin. And of course, the Bybit exchange, which is an awesome exchange to trade Bitcoin and a variety of altcoins with leverage. Right now, if you sign up using my affiliate link down below, you can get an additional bonus of $90 when you deposit 0.2 Bitcoin. So guys, for all the traders out there who want to trade Bitcoin, you can find all my affiliate links down below in the pinned comment. So guys, when we have a look at the Bitcoin price, right now we are looking at the 1 hour time frame, and I want to draw a parallel channel right here to show you where I think Bitcoin is trading in right now. I do think Bitcoin is trading in a sideways range, and we can have the support right here, a horizontal support at approximately 22,400, and we have the resistance at the top at approximately 24,200. So this is quite a broad range, approximately 1,000 or 900 US dollar range, where Bitcoin is trading between support and resistance. If we have a look at the middle of the channel right here, then you can see that the middle of the channel is clearly getting respected, right? We have seen multiple touches, multiple times that we got rejected from this level. And once we are trading above it, we are seeing a push to the upside. And after, this level is acting as support. And right now, Bitcoin is trading back above the middle of the channel. So that has changed since yesterday, right? But we are still trading in this sideways range. And we also expected Bitcoin to continue trading in this sideways range due to the fact that we are seeing these bearish divergences, right? We have these bearish divergences on the 1 hour time frame. We are seeing them on the 4 hour time frame as well, right here, when the price is creating a higher high. But in the RSI, we have been setting a lower high, as you can see right here. But these are not the only bearish divergences that we are seeing, because on the daily time frame, we also have a bearish divergence, and this is quite a steep one, where we've set in the price a higher high, as you can see right here, and in the RSI, we have been setting a lower high. So this is definitely showing us that the momentum, the bullish momentum right here, is running out of its steam, guys. And guys, that's as well the reason why I do think that Bitcoin in the shorter term time frame is more likely to range sideways or even slightly to the downside. But yeah, right here we have a clear sideways channel where Bitcoin is trading in right now. But guys, the interesting thing about the price action we are seeing right here is that this price action really looks similar to the price action we have seen in 2019, right before the blow off top started in the price of Bitcoin, where Bitcoin blasted to 13,800, 13,900, depending on which exchange you were looking. And from there, we were seeing a blow off top. So guys, I want to bring out the fractal where the price action right now we are seeing in Bitcoin looks very similar to the price action we have seen in 2019. So right here on the left side, we can see the price action right now. And here on the right side, we can see the price action of 2019, where we had this rally. And finally, we peaked out at approximately 13,700 in this chart. It depends on which chart you're looking at. But yeah, if we would draw a line right here, we can see that we are actually seeing something similar. We have a sideways range, right, where Bitcoin is actually trading between support and resistance. And guys, if we are zooming in on this price action, then we can see a lot of similarities. Actually, we've exited a uprising channel to the upside. We broke above the resistance and we've entered a sideways channel. Once in the sideways channel, we've been trading below the half of the channel, below the middle of the channel. Afterwards, we broke back above it. We're bouncing. This level was acting as support. We broke back below it and we broke back above it. Something similar we have seen right here in 2019 as well. We were trading below it, got rejected multiple times from the middle of the channel, trade back above it, backtested the former resistance as support, break back below it, and eventually in 2019, we broke back above the middle of the channel. We broke the resistance of the sideways channel. We backtested the former resistance as support, and we saw a huge bounce. And from the breakout, we have seen a bounce of approximately 55%. So guys, that is a huge blow off top, which occurred in 2019 after we have left that sideways range. And guys, the interesting thing right here is when we have a look at the momentum indicators, and let me get rid of the camera for a second so you can see clearly what is happening, is that within this sideways range, when Bitcoin is moving sideways, actually the price is moving sideways, right, we are seeing that the RSI is moving to the downside. And that is normally a bullish sign, and that is as well something we have seen in 2019. The price is generally moving sideways within this channel, but the RSI is going to the downside. And that's also needed, of course, because when Bitcoin is heavily overbought, it needs to calm down. The momentum indicators needs to calm down in order to prepare for another run to the upside. And yeah, the most logical way to do that is for the price to move sideways and the RSI to move downwards. So guys, one major difference between the price action right here in 2019 and the price action right now is that in 2019, we haven't seen this bearish divergence on the daily time frame, which we are seeing right now. Right now, Bitcoin set a higher high, but in the RSI, we have been setting a lower high, showing a bearish divergence. And in the price action of 2019, we haven't been seeing that. Then guys, it will be very important to keep on watching this chart. I will be talking about this chart on the channel as well, but this is the US dollar index chart. I've been talking about this chart a lot and about the inverse correlation this chart has with the Bitcoin chart. And right now we are seeing some potential signs that we are going to get a bounce in this chart, which actually is a bearish sign for Bitcoin, because when the US dollar index is increasing, most of the time the price of Bitcoin is decreasing due to the fact that they have a inverse correlation. And if we have a look at the momentum indicators, then on the RSI we have a bullish divergence. But if we have a look at the MACD on the daily time frame, we have a bullish divergence as well. And we got a bullish cross, which is showing us that right here on the daily time frame, we could be seeing a bounce right here. And yeah, if we are going to see an aggressive bounce to the upside, or at least going to see an increase right here in the Dixie chart, then that definitely could have a bearish effect on the price of Bitcoin. So guys, always take in mind that when you are trading Bitcoin, you have to have a look at the US dollar index as well. Then guys, I quickly want to share my take about the S&P 500, because yeah, the S&P 500 I do think is in shorter term time frames heavily linked with other assets as well as with Bitcoin. So if we are going to see a huge drop in the S&P 500, then we are also going to see that in Bitcoin, or at least it's going to create selling pressure on the price of Bitcoin. And right now, when we have a look at the price action of the S&P 500, then it looks like the momentum is actually slowing down. So guys, right in the S&P 500, we can see that we have been setting a higher high in the price, but in the momentum indicators, we have been setting lower highs, as well as in the RSI as well as on the MACD. So this is showing us that the momentum right here in the S&P 500 is actually slowing down. We can see as well the price action right now. We have been testing this horizontal support multiple times. I do think that as long as we are trading above this level, we definitely can expect an increase right here in the S&P 500. However, if we were to break some key support levels, then I think that definitely could lead to a bigger sell-off. And guys, one of the best charts to predict whether the S&P 500 is looking bearish or not is of course the volatility index, the VIX chart. We have been predicting a lot of drops in the S&P 500 due to this chart. And yeah, let me show you some examples, because this chart has an inverse correlation with the S&P 500, which means that once this chart is increasing, breaking through some resistance, we are seeing bearish signals in the price of the S&P 500, most of the time a drop. Let me compare the SPX chart on top of this chart. Then we can see right here, for example, when we had a declining resistance and eventually the VIX broke the declining resistance and saw a spike to the upside, that was the exact moment right here you can see that we have seen a drop in the S&P 500. We have been predicting this right here on the channel. Then right here we can see another declining resistance. And yeah, the moment we broke above this declining resistance, backtested the former resistance as support and saw a nice bounce off from that. Guys, that was the exact moment that we are seeing a drop right here in the S&P 500. Then guys, we have another example right here. We have a declining resistance and eventually we broke above the declining resistance, backtest the former resistance as support and see a nice bounce in the VIX, which equals a decrease in the price of the S&P 500. So guys, can you see the significance right here? There is a direct inverse correlation between the VIX chart and the S&P 500. But these charts as well have an impact on the price of Bitcoin. So therefore, it's always important to look for confirmations on multiple charts. And right now, we are seeing the VIX actually still at low levels, but we are seeing a clear horizontal resistance. So we have a horizontal resistance approximately right here, which on the VIX chart is the level of 25. If we were to break above this level decisively, backtested as support, of course, and we could see a bounce from this level, then that is a very bearish sign for the S&P 500, signaling us early on that we might see a drop to the downside, that we might break some key support levels, but could as well signal us that we are going to see selling pressure on the price of Bitcoin. So guys, I'm watching this chart very closely as well. So guys, I want to have a quick talk about Ethereum, but as well about the Bitcoin dominance and yeah, potential scenario that could be happening. Okay, so first of all, normally I would say I would be very bullish on Ethereum, especially when Bitcoin surpassed previous all-time high, and I am very bullish on Ethereum, I have to say. However, in the immediate short term, we are seeing some bearish signals, because right here, if I bring out the momentum indicators, then we can see we have a bearish divergence right here with the RSI. We have a bearish divergence right here with the MACD on the daily time frame. And pattern wise, we could be forming a rising wedge pattern, right? Where we have a uptrending resistance, a uptrending support in a narrowing pattern, which eventually is a bearish pattern. So guys, I still want to stay neutral right here in the Ethereum chart due to the fact that we haven't broken any key support levels. However, when I'm looking at the momentum indicators, then it surely looks like that right here, the bullish momentum is definitely slowing down, and that we should at least be aware of the fact that we might see some bearish price action or some bearish momentum right here in the price of Ethereum. Then guys, I want to have a quick talk about the Bitcoin dominance, because we have been talking about this broadening channel, right? This megaphone pattern where Bitcoin was ranging in a broadening pattern, in a declining broadening pattern, but eventually we broke the resistance, the declining resistance, and we saw a push to the upside. So the Bitcoin dominance right now is still looking very bullish, which is the complete opposite like we have seen the previous time Bitcoin surpassing previous all-time highs, because that was approximately right here. And as you can see, the moment we were surpassing previous all-time highs, the Bitcoin dominance declined very rapidly. which means, guys, that that was a perfect moment to speculate into altcoins, and you could make a lot of Bitcoin speculating into altcoins the previous time Bitcoin surpassed all-time high. So right now we are seeing a complete different market structure. That is also what makes it difficult to predict what we are going to see right now. But I do think we can actually still go into both directions. We are seeing a bullish signs right now that we broke above this megaphone pattern, and it definitely could spike the Bitcoin dominance to higher levels. However, we are also going to approach a very important resistance level or resistance zone approximately right here, which also could be a moment where the Bitcoin dominance could see a rejection and where more liquidity from Bitcoin is flowing into altcoins. Because guys, if we have a look at the human emotions, then speculating into altcoins does make a lot of sense, because we are seeing, of course, the greed increasing in Bitcoin, but at a certain point you cannot get the returns on Bitcoin as you can get with altcoins. So a normal human reaction is that you are experiencing more greed, so you want to speculate into altcoins where you can get more gains than that you can actually can with Bitcoin. So I do think that from a psychological perspective, Bitcoin surpassing previous all-time highs, it does make a lot of sense that more liquidity is eventually going to flow into altcoins, because there's a lot of confidence in the markets. So therefore, guys, I'm also going to I also want to share the following scenario with you, and that is that right here we broke the declining resistance of this megaphone pattern, which eventually could lead to a surge right here in the Bitcoin dominance. But it is possible that we are going to top out right here at this horizontal resistance and eventually see a rejection from that, and that the Bitcoin dominance can come down from there, and from there we are going to see an altcoin season. Guys, that is a scenario that I want to share with you so that you can be prepared, or at least be aware that this is a possibility as well. So when we are increasing right now in the Bitcoin dominance, it is very bullish for Bitcoin, bearish for altcoins. However, do take in mind we are approaching a very important resistance level in the Bitcoin dominance, where we as well could see a rejection from. Then guys, quick summary right here on the price of Bitcoin. We are seeing a lot of mixed signals. I have to be honest, we are trading in this sideways range, but we are seeing some bearish divergences, 1 hour time frame, 4 hour time frame, and another divergence on the daily time frame. And that is concerning me a little bit, because that's showing us that the momentum, the bullish momentum, is slowing down. However, we have some examples that Bitcoin is ignoring these divergences in the past. However, the divergence on the daily time frame, I do think, is quite significant, and it's not something we are seeing that often. So I think we have to take that sign very seriously. Right now, Bitcoin is trading in this sideways range, a range where the support is at approximately 22,400. And yeah, the resistance at approximately 24,200. Then I definitely expect the moment Bitcoin is going to break the resistance of this range, we might be seeing the fractal playing out we have seen in 2019, where we have seen in a short term time frame a huge surge in the price of Bitcoin, which eventually will be followed by a blow off top event. That's definitely possible. If we were to break the support right here of the sideways channel, that would be a very bearish sign, and I would expect Bitcoin to drop to lower levels. Then guys, the main reason why I do think that when Bitcoin is breaking the support of the sideways channel, that we can see a continuational drop to the downside, is due to the fact that the support of the sideways channel is aligning with a lot of different important support levels. So first of all, when we go to the 4 hour time frame, and I want to bring out the 50 moving average right here, which is a very important moving average showing whether we are in a uptrend or in a downtrend, right? Then you can see that it is approaching the support of the sideways channel, and the former resistance of the uprising channel is as well aligning with this in the near future. So guys, these are important levels to watch. The moment Bitcoin is going to break out of the sideways channel, either to the upside or to the downside, I do think can bring definitely a explosive move. Then guys, for all the traders out there who are interested in trading Bitcoin, you can trade Bitcoin on a couple of exchanges. I have some affiliate links down below in the pinned comment, and when you are using my affiliate link to sign up to that certain exchange, you can get a additional bonus. So I'm personally using free exchanges and I'm using PrimeXBT. And PrimeXBT I use for trading Bitcoin, but as well for trading the S&P 500. They also have a nice co-investing module where you can copy other traders, or other traders can copy you, and you can earn based on their trades. And if you sign up using my affiliate link down below, you can get a 50% deposit bonus and a 25% discount on your fees. Then next to that, I'm using the Femex platform for margin trading, but as well for spot trading. The Femex platform is a very nice exchange with a very good user interface, a nice user experience as well. If you sign up using my affiliate link down below, you can get an additional bonus of $100 once you deposit 0.2 Bitcoin. And last but not least, I'm using the Bybit exchange as well. And the Bybit exchange is a very good exchange if you want to trade Bitcoin or altcoins with leverage. And if you sign up using my affiliate link down below, you can get an additional bonus of $90 when you deposit 0.2 Bitcoin. Then for all the traders out there who are wanting to take the next step in their trading journey, you can still sign up for my cryptocurrency trading course with the 33% Christmas discount. And guys, do take in mind, you only have a couple of days left to enroll for the cryptocurrency trading course with the discount. After New Year, the discount will be gone and the course will be sold for $299. Right now, you can still enroll for $199. And guys, I'm getting a lot of good reactions from everyone who has enrolled to my cryptocurrency trading course. For a lot of people, it has been life-changing. Guys, so if you want to enroll for my cryptocurrency trading course, or you want to read more about it, you want to get more information, you can go to the blockchaintoday.com. I have a link down below in the description as well. Then guys, I wish all of you an amazing day. And for everyone who hasn't seen one of my awesome tutorials, you can go over there, watch one of those, and I will see you all in the next video.